Theater in Rio Grande City, Texas. We've got 3A football for you here on 956sports.com. Our friends at McDonald's and all of our proud sponsors here on 956 Sport proudly bring to you Valley High School football. Today, on Thursday night game of the week, it's Port Isabel taking on the Grulla Gators. Hi, everyone. Alex Del Barrio live here at Joe R. Sanchez Stadium. Glad you could make us a part of your day here on 956sports.com. A couple of 2-2, 3A teams going at it here at Joe R. Sanchez Stadium. And based on our history coming to the stadium, you're in store for a good one. Both teams coming in at 2-2. Port Isabel coming off a big victory over St. Joseph's Academy in Brownsville, 51-30, winning that game. Their other victory came against Lyford at Lyford, 22-18. That was back on September the 7th. As for the Grulla Gators, they come into this game also at 2-2 on the season. Their victories came in the first week of the season back on the 31st of August, a 42-14 win against La Villa. That was here at Joe R. Sanchez Stadium. And then a couple of weeks ago on September the 14th against PSJA Southwest, winning that game 27-6. Their game last week, a loss to Rio Hondo on the road at Rio Hondo, 30-6. They're hoping to mount a little bit more offense in this game against Port Isabel. Grulla in the blue uniform, tops, blue pants, blue helmets. Going to be a little bit confusing to watch, but just keep an eye on the screen there. Grulla, you can see the logo at the top will be in blue with white lettering. That's exactly how they'll be on the field. PI is wearing their white uniform, tops, blue numerals, blue pants, blue helmets with the white striping as well. Port Isabel in the white will be kicking off here to the Grulla Gators. They'll be moving from right to left offensively. It's a high kick. It'll be fair caught at the 40, and that's exactly where the Grulla Gators will take over here for their first drive of the football game. Again, Grulla receiving. They'll be moving from left to right offensively across your computer screen to start this one off here at Joe R. Sanchez Stadium in Rio Grande City. So just underway. Glad to have you aboard here on 956sports.com. It's Grulla taking the field. Raymond Peña Blanca takes the huddle now. He is the quarterback for the Grulla Gators as they'll start off at their own 39-yard line, first down and 10, up on that left hash mark. Going out of that spread offense, shotgun formation, four wide receivers, one man in the backfield. Peña Blanca, the quarterback, standing at his own 34-yard line. Takes the snap, back to pass, three-step drop, looking, firing over right side, and it's between the hands and incomplete. Just a bit overthrew the intended target, number 84, Steve Cerda. And he'll go back to the huddle. It'll be second down and 10 after the incompletion. Another big game on the schedule tonight. Weslaco taking on PSJ Memorial. That game at PSJ Stadium, the new and improved PSJ Stadium. But this is a big one here in 3A football. Four wide receivers again. They'll put a man in motion. That's Troy Triades in motion there. So three wide receivers to that right side. He's lined up in that slot spot. The handoff goes right up the middle. Number 32, Heriberto Bazan with the carry. Picks up about 4 yards there for the Gators. And it's going to be third down and long, but it'll be third and maybe about six after about a 4 yard pickup there. We'll see what they put officially. They're going to spot the football with the nose of the football at the 43 yard line. So third down and six to go here for Grulla if they want to pick up a first down. Again, Grulla in the blue, Port Isabel in the white uniform. Peña Blanca, the quarterback, they'll put a man in motion. That is Cerda. Three receivers to the left, one all the way out to that right side. Rolling out to the left is Peña Blanca. He'll change gears over to the right. Plenty of running room. Gets across the 45. Outside the hash marks. Gets across midfield at inside Port Isabel territory. Plenty of room for him to run and pick up the first down and get inside Port Isabel territory.
First down.
So first and 10 here for Grulla.
The mariachi from Grulla High School is selling fajita tacos.
So he gets all the way to the 47-yard line of Port Isabel on that quarterback keeper. It wasn't the design QB keeper, but he found some running room there. That was Raymond Peña Blanca, the quarterback for Grulla. So now the Gators will line up on that right hash mark now. Three receivers bunched up right, but to put a man in motion, that's Triades. Line up on that left slot, one man in the backfield, and looks like we have maybe some offsides here as Peña Blanca takes it right side. I don't see any penalty markers come out, but I thought I saw a couple of the defensive linemen take an early step, but I don't see a flag out there. We do see a discussion here. And they'll switch the football, and no gain on the carry. So it'll be second down and 10. Ball still at the 47-yard line. Still on that right hash mark. Three wide receivers to the right, one all the way to the left. Cesar Morado is all the way to the left outside the numbers. And a hard count again, and this time they jump, and this time we get some contact at the line of scrimmage. Now the laundry comes out. And we get the word from Bobby Rutledge, the official.
First quarter sponsor.
No replacement officials in RGV High School football this year. Although we did have an RGV official make it as a replacement official in the National Football League.
Also, Molina and Mendez Financial Services, they offer bookkeeping.
No score here, 9:50 to play here in the opening quarter. Grulla versus Port Isabel. Glad to have you aboard, 956sports.com. Benya Blanca is the quarterback. He lines up out of that shotgun, standing at the Port Isabel 46-yard line. There's an end around here. It's a number 84, Steve Sevda.
Number 84, that's
takes
Steve
it left
Sevda.
Side. No gain. He might have actually lost a yard as well. And it's going to be third down, and it looks like tackle, about 4 yards to go. Well, he's going to lose a yard officially. So it looks like he may be third and five. Third and six. Looks a little bit longer than five. Ball spotted at the 42-yard line of the Tarpons. They picked up the first down the last time they were on third down. So one for one on third down conversions for the Gators. Back to pass, firing, and the pass is complete, but the ball comes loose. Beanbags come out. Who's going to be on top of it? That ball kind of squirted out a couple of times. Pass was complete to number 88. That's Nathan Salinas with the reception. And then he just kind of slipped out. Now, we've had some rain here in the area over the last half hour or so. We were all worrying if we might get a lightning delay for this game, but we started right on time. But you can bet the field here, which is still a natural surface at Joe R. Sanchez Stadium, probably a little slippery, as are the footballs. So, Tarpons couldn't come up with it after the fumble. The Grulla Gators still have it, first down and 10, and another third down conversion for the Gators. Benya Blanca, the quarterback, fakes the handoff, and he's brought down in the backfield after faking the handoff. He's going to lose a couple of yards there. It'll be second down. We invite you to follow us on Twitter. Follow the general 956 Sports Twitter at 956 Sports. You can follow me at RGV Sports Guy. We'll keep you updated on Valley High School football throughout the weekend. Make sure you do that. Hashtag RGV Week 4. Week 4 Valley High School football. Again, at 956 Sports, at RGV Sports Guy. Benya Blanc out of the shotgun, takes the snap. Back to pass on the three-step. Now steps up on the pocket, rolls to the left, and now he's taken off across the 30. Tries to step forward, got his tippy toes just shy of the 25, and then took a step back and angled out of bounds over to the left side. And it's going to be third down and about one to go after about the 11-yard pickup there from Benya Blanc. Taking a look at the replay over on the video board. The mini Godzillatron they have here at Rio Grande City CISD's football stadium, Joe R. Sanchez. 7:18 to play, opening quarter, still no score. Grulla on their opening drive of the game. Third down and a long one. It's going to be two officially. They'll put a man in motion, this time out of the shotgun, faking the handoff. And Benya Blanca takes it right side, and he's brought down from behind. Big tackle from behind by number 42, Esteban Montelongo, bringing him down in the backfield. And this is, I think, four-down territory here if you're Grulla. You're in that iffy area between the 40 and the 20, where it's almost too close to kick to punt it and too far to kick a field goal. So it's going to be fourth down and about four to go here. Ball just inside the 30 at the 29-yard line. So fourth and four here, 6:28 to play in the opening quarter. Three receivers bunched up to the right. They'll fake the handoff again. Peña Blanca calls his own number, and he stops short. Three white shirts bring him down, led by number two, Danny Medina. And turnover on downs for the Grulla Gators, and it will be Port Isabel football.
29-yard line.
So 0-for-1 on fourth down conversions here in this quarter, or on that drive, I should say, for Grulla. Now Port Isabel will take over. They're going with their third-string quarterback. Monty Stamba told us before the game. Monty Stamba, a longtime head coach there at Port Isabel. Ball at the 30-yard line of the Tarpons. Number 10, Louis Bennett, L.B. Bennett, is taking over here. He's under center out of that I formation. Oh, and a big hit in the backfield. That was number 24, Joel Villarreal, tackling the ball carrier there. Number 24, Jacob Lasoya was the ball carrier for Port Isabel. Didn't carry the ball very far. In fact, he lost a couple of yards. Second down and 12 is what it'll be. Now, that was a brutal opening hit, and defense for the Grulla Gators setting the tone early here at home. 5:48 to play in the opening quarter. Tarpons will break the huddle. Old school football in Port Isabel, going out of the I formation. Two wide receivers, two men in the backfield. Fumble, and the snap ball is loose. And they'll blow the play dead, and I believe the Gators have it. They do. So just two offensive plays for Port Isabel on that drive. One resulted in a 3-yard loss. The other a fumble and a turnover.
We'll take the ball in Tarpon territory at the 29-yard line, 28-yard line.
So both teams with a turnover now. And the Gators will once again breathe new life, just about in the same spot they were when they turned it over on downs. Gators will break the huddle here. Again, Grulla in the blue, moving from left to right. Port Isabel just coughed it up. They move from right to left when they get the football again. Three wide receivers, one man in the slot, two men in the backfield joining Peña Blanca. Takes it, hands it off. Nice spin move there. And looks like number... Well, looks like there was a fumble against number 54. Brandon Solis came up with the football.
Brings up a second down.
Ball's now at the 21-yard line, second down. So he did fumble the football, huh? And Brandon Solis bailed him out. Again, talk about the slippery surface here in Rio Grande City tonight. The valley's gotten a lot of rain, and it was coming westward here. Got all the way to Rio Grande City. Came down pretty hard for about 40 minutes. So you can bet the surface is a little bit mushy down there. And Peña Blanca tried to take it right side. It was hit almost immediately. Part of the tackle there was Danny Medina of Port Isabel. Well, I guess if you're the Gators and you're going to call your facility the Swamp when you play home games, you might as well get some rain before. Don't think you could really call it the Swamp if they had an artificial surface here, right? I don't know how you would make it swampy. Third down and three. Four wide receivers here. Peña Blanca out of the shotgun's got one man in the backfield. Standing at the 25. Peña Blanca back to pass. Steps up in the pocket. Now he's going to tuck it and run across the 20. Dives forward towards the 15. He only needed to get to the 19, so he picks up the first down. But you're seeing Peña Blanca kind of struggle here a little bit. He threw that one incompletion.
That's enough for him.
And then the last couple of times he's dropped back, he's decided to not go through his progressions. He hasn't really felt any pressure, but just decided to tuck and run. Nevertheless, it's been working for him. He's picked up a first down here. Another third down conversion. And Peña Blanca almost goes to a knee after taking a low snap. He does hand it off to Joel Villarreal. And he's going to lose a yard here.
Joel Villarreal.
Welcome those of you for pulling this one in here, 956sports.com. Tell a friend. Tell them we got live high school football for you here on 956sports.com. We'll have another one for you tomorrow that we'll archive. We'll have the game for you after. four wide receivers here, one man in the backfield to put a man in motion. That's Triaya. And Peña Blanca back to pass, fires, and that was wide.
As intended for number 88.
Looked like he zigged when he should have zagged.
Third down.
Intended receiver was Nathan Salinas. Pass was very well behind him as if he was looking like he was going on a post to the outside. Instead, Salinas was going on the inside and was not ready for the football. Miscommunication there. Back to a third down situation. Third down and 11. Three wide receivers, or four wide receivers, I should say. Peña Blanca back to pass, firing left side. The call kind of fluttered there, but he caught it. And did he get inside? No, they're going to say he's just short. Great slant as Salinas comes up with it. And
at the 1 yard line,
you could tell the ball kind of fluttered out of the hands of Peña Blanca, but he was able to still get it there. And he was able to get the right arm in. I guess he forgot which hand had the football because he threw his right arm across the goal line, not the left arm. Nevertheless, he got down first and goal at the 1. Another third down conversion. They're 4 for 5 on third down here in the football game. Peña Blanca still out of the gun, and we're going to whistle, and we're going to get a false start here. This one's coming back to the 6.
False start on the offense. 5-yard penalty.
2:36 left in this opening quarter, and we got a timeout taken by Grulla, so we'll take one as well here on 956sports.com.
Well, I think you don't know who we are, what we do. These girls showed up. They all dressed up, and they thought it was a dance hall. We wanted people to know that we're building a
podcast. Happy birthday to Troy Triaye.
Man, you guys have got a great deal. I didn't know you were here. I mean, we've been here for over 40 years.
We'd like to thank our fine sponsors for this beautiful scoreboard we have here tonight. The Tango Software, South Texas College, Stark County Teachers Credit Union.
Back here at Joe R. Sanchez Stadium here in Rio Grande City. 3A high school football here on 956sports.com. 2:36 to play in the opening quarter. Still no score between the Grulla Gators and the Port Isabel Tarpons. Alex Zabaria here. Glad to have you aboard on 956sports.com.
Peter, Melissa, Aubrey, Amador.
The Gators right at the doorstep here. Looking to punch it into pay dirt. Got all the way to the 1, but now it's first and goal from the 6 after a false start penalty. Peña Blanca, the quarterback, takes the snap, hands off, gets some running room, diving ahead, but his knee came down. The running back was number 24, Joel Villarreal. Boy, he had a burst of steam, turning those legs, but just got tripped up, got that knee down. Let's see where he got to. They're going to give him all the way to the, looks like the 1 yard line again. So it'll be second and goal from the 1. So back where they started from. They just took him down to get him there. 2:06 to play here until this first quarter comes to a close. Again, the Gators, who've churned off a lot of time in this quarter. Handoff again, into the end zone, touchdown Gators, as Villarreal punches it in the end zone from 1 yard out, and the Gators have taken a 6-0 lead here on Port Isabel. So now the lineup for the extra point. In to kick the extra point, Robert Camarillo. Left-footed kicker, the kick is up, and that one is good. 1:55 to play here until this first quarter comes to a close. Grulla strikes first on their second drive of the football game. They lead it 7-0 over Port Isabel. Welcome. We'll be back in a second here on 956sports.com.
From your proud family to Adam Cantu.
Is it tear in one of the hamstring muscles? Symptoms of a pulled hamstring include a sudden sharp pain at the back of the leg during exercise, pain on stretching the muscle, pain on contracting the muscle against resistance, swelling and bruising, and if the rupture is severe enough, a gap in the muscle can be felt. Strains are graded 1, 2, or 3 depending on severity. Grade 1 consists of minor tears, grade 2 is a partial tear, and grade 3 is a severe or complete rupture of the muscle. It is important that treatment for a pulled hamstring starts immediately following the injury. The most important phase for treatment is the first 48 hours. Physical therapy is vital for the correct rehabilitation of the muscle. Physical therapy would include strengthening and stretching
and
exercises in the pain-free range of
motion. Squad,
in addition, the exercises will ensure that the new tissue laid down will be in the correct orientation to decrease risk of re-injury.
Back here at Joe R. Sanchez Stadium here in Rio Grande City. 7-0 Grulla strikes first on their second drive of the game, taking advantage of a Port Isabel fumble in their own territory, and they lead it 7-0, 1-yard touchdown run by number 24, Joel Villarreal, set up by a big reception by Nathan Salinas. So a kick on its way, and it's caught inside the 5-yard line. Plenty of room up the middle. Got some
on the return, number 7.
Upset Grulla fans here, wanting maybe a hold or a block in the back.
By number 13, Manuel Barba.
And it looks like Port Isabel will take over
at
here at the
25-yard
line. That's where it'll be. Again, follow us on Twitter at 956 Sports, or you can follow me at RGB Sports Guy. If you want to chime in on the broadcast, just send us a tweet. We'll be happy to chime in and read it here on the broadcast. First down and 10, ball at the 25-yard line. The quarterback for Port Isabel, Louis Bennett. Or Lewis Bennett. It's under center here as they go out of that I formation. Handoff goes to the tailback. And plenty of running room there after escaping a couple of tackles there. Number 22, Juan Aguilera on the carry there. Got some big yardage as he got all the way to the 43-yard line.
Number 31, first down.
So an 18-yard pickup there. And that'll be first down and 10 from the 43. Well, an offset eye now, pitched left side. A big hit there after crossing the line of scrimmage. I believe that was Aguilera again.
Number 22.
But it was Aguilera again.
Juan Aguilera.
Tall, strong runner.
On the tackle.
There for Port Isabel.
For the Tarpons.
It was from the 43. About the 48, so the 5-yard pickup, so second down and 5. Tarpons will break the huddle, finally able to put a couple of offensive plays together, go back to the I formation, extra tight end, one wide receiver, pitch right side. This time it's Lasoya on the carry, as he's just shy of the first down, but does get across midfield. And inside Grulla territory, it's going to be third down and about 2 as he takes it to the Grulla 49-yard line.
Down and about 3 yards to go for the Tarpons.
So third down and 3 coming up here. Third down and 3. Ball just across midfield. Handoff. Good. Just shy. Again, that was Aguilera on the carry. He might have gotten the forward progress. He needed to get to the 46-yard line. They spot the football right at the 46, so they are just going to give him the first down. I thought he was a bit short, but looks like they gave him just enough.
From your family, we love you. Keep making us proud.
So we've reached the end of the first quarter. Our score at the end of 12 minutes of football. Grulla on the 1-yard touchdown run by Joel Villarreal leads Port Isabel 7-0 here on 956sports.com.
I don't know who we are, what we do. These girls showed up. They all dressed up and they thought it was a dance hall. We wanted people to know that we're building material. Lots of cash and carry building material. People come in and they're surprised. Man, you guys have got great deals. I didn't know you were here. I mean, we've been here for over 40 years. And you thought the good old days were gone?
Back here on 956sports.com as we start the second quarter. Port Isabel with the football now inside Gator territory. They lose a yard here, so it'll be second down and 11.
Second and 11 for the Tarpons.
Tarpons will break the huddle here, second down and 11. Tarpons out of the I formation. They fake the handoff, play action here. Rolling to the left side, pass incomplete. They wanted a pass interference call. The intended target was Gordo Garza. It says it on the roster, so I get to say it. But misfire there from Bennett. It will be third down and 11 now. Big third down coming up here for Port Isabel. Tarpons break the huddle. Under center, offset I formation. Two wide receivers here. Back to pass here is Bennett. Firing left side. It flutters and the pass is intercepted. Gallegos has it here for the Gators. Slips at the 35. Gets near the 40. And another turnover by Port Isabel. And the Gators will take over. Again, you can tell the slippery surface and perhaps the slippery football is causing these teams to maybe not go to the air as often. We saw that ball just kind of stay in the air, hung up like a hanging change up to a big slugger. It was just a giant beach ball coming away.
Supporting the Gators 100%
of Eduardo Gallegos, who had the interception.
Need to meet with him, call him at 487-8889.
So Port Isabel with their second turnover of the half. And now Grulla has their third drive of the football game. On the rush to that right side is Joel Villarreal, but he stopped
off to number 24.
After just a short pickup there.
Brings up a second down. Also a proud sponsor of the Gators, JF Utility Trenching.
7-0 Grulla, 1 yard touchdown run by Joel Villarreal. As the Gators on top, they scored on their second drive of the game, taking advantage of a fumble recovery inside Port Isabel territory. Neither team has punted. Grulla turned it over on their first drive, turned it over on downs. This is their third drive. Benya Blanca, the quarterback, back to pass. Slant route, fires a pass, is complete. Getting across the 40 as they get inside Port Isabel territory. That's Cesar Morado on the reception. And he's inside the 40 to about the 39-yard line. And a first down here for Grulla. And they continue to move the football offensively. Grulla in the blue. They're moving from right to left here in the second quarter. Port Isabel, when they get the football again, they'll be moving from left to right across your computer screen. First down and 10. Ball at the 39-yard line of the Tarpons. And now they'll run that play clock, and the Gators will break the huddle here. Ball lined up on that left hash. Gators send four wide receivers out there. One man in the backfield to put a man in motion. That's Triades. And on the end around, takes the snap, and then he just runs into a lot of white jerseys before he can get to the line of scrimmage.
The birthday boy.
9:55 to go until we reach the half. 7-0. Both of these teams keeping the ball on the ground for the most part. Probably count the total pass plays on your hands for both teams combined. Second down and 11. Ball at the 40. Four wide receivers. Benya Blanca, the quarterback, standing at the 45-yard line. He'll step up in the pocket, fires, and the pass is complete to Triades as he gets across the 30 to the 29, 28-yard line. And that should be good enough for another Grulla first down.
That's enough for a Gator first
They do
down.
Give him the first down. They have the football between the 29 and the 28-yard line. 9:21 to play until the half. And keep the clock moving now. After they reset the change now, kind of a bunch formation, but still out of that shotgun. Hand off goes to Villarreal.
Hand off to number 24.
You might have to rethink the running game here if you're Grulla, because last three or four running plays have been pretty much nothing, a yard, nothing. Loss a yard there, so second down and 11. Ball behind the 29-yard line. Four receivers. Peña Blanca standing at the 34-yard line. Blanca back to pass, firing left side. He's got one man to beat, but he overthrows his intended target. That's Triades again. He's thrown his way a few times.
Up a third down for the Gators.
So now in another third down situation here for Grulla. By my count, they're 4 for 5 on third down conversions. They love these third down situations. They'll send three receivers to the right, one outside the numbers to the left. Peña Blanca takes the snap. Back to pass. Now he'll step up. He's got one man to beat. Gets across the 25. Now we get a flag comes down. He tried to dive forward to the first down. I think he had enough as he got to the 19-yard line. That's where he needed to get the first, but the penalty markers come out. I believe we may have a hold here against Grulla. Get the word from referee Bobby Rutledge.
You're in a run, but any legal ball in the back on the offense. A 10-yard penalty. Still third down.
So a 10-yard penalty called against Grulla. Now, it's from the spot of the foul, the 10-yard penalty, so they'll basically go back to where the line of scrimmage was. This time, they'll mark it just about the 30-yard line. So, four wide receivers, third down and 11. So, it's basically a do-over here for Grulla. Peña Blanca back to pass. Now, he'll step up again. This time, he's running out of running room, and he's brought down from behind. Number 82, Pedro Luis Villarreal. But Puerto Isabel sure does like putting these nicknames on the roster. Pedro Luis Villarreal, PLV, in quotation marks there on the roster. It's going to bring up fourth down, and Grulla going to go for it. Last time they were on fourth down situation, they turned it over on downs. PSG Memorial with a 3-0 lead on Weslaco. We get a timeout taken by Grulla. We'll take one as well here on 956sports.com.
To the Grulla Gators from Kayla, Kelly, and George.
It's not a dance-off, you know. A lot of people don't know who we are, what we do. These girls showed up one day all dressed up, and they thought it was a dance-off. We wanted people to know that we're building materials. Mott's Cash and Carry building materials. People come in and they're surprised. Man, you guys have got great deals. I didn't know you were here. I mean, we've been here for over 40 years. And you thought the good old days were gone forever? We're still here. Mott's Cash and Carry building materials. It's not a dance-off, you know. A lot of people don't know.
Fourth down and 11 coming up here for Grulla. Rolling to his right. Peña Blanca looking long, firing. That pass going to go in and out of the hands of Nathan Salinas, and that will be pass incomplete. 0 for 2 on fourth down for the Grulla Gators, and now the Tarpons will take over. They've turned it over on both of their possessions, once on a fumble, the other on an interception. Both teams with two turnovers in the football game. Neither team has punted yet. Tarpons, oh, nearly cough it up again. This time they've got Zach Reeves in at quarterback for Port Isabel. Got into a collision there. A lot of miscommunication going on in this football game. Loss of a couple of yards. It'll be second down and 12.
From Mr. and Mrs. Elmira Perez. Happy early birthday.
Quarterback keeper there from Reeves.
Number 11, Zach Reeves.
Gets it back to the 35-yard line. Just shy of it, actually. It'll be third down here for Port Isabel. Just trying to mount something offensively here against Grulla. Moved the ball pretty well a couple of times. Juan Aguilera had a couple of nice carries there in the last drive for Port Isabel. Remember, the drive stalled because of an interception, not because of a lack of moving the chains on the carries. Out of the I formation again. This time, quarterback Reeves will roll to his left. Look for some running room, and it's going to be a little shy of the first down marker. Only gain of about 5 yards here. It's about a yard shy of the first down marker. Looks like they're going to go for it here. It's going to be fourth down and about one to go. You need to get inside, or pardon me, outside the 40-yard line. There's a carry there. Looks like they're going to get the first down. Aguilera with the carry there for Port Isabel. And they're going to pick up the first down.
In Garcia's lawsuit, they specialize in state and federal criminal defense, wrongful death, personal injury. Call the Garcia lawsuit, 956-488-8170.
So first down here for the Tarpons. Well, just outside the 40, and a great pickup there defensively. Won't get credit for the tackle, but
and up to
number 24, Joel Villarreal, did a nice job of getting inside and tripping up the runner, who was also number 24, Jacob Lasoya. 2 yard loss there for the Tarpons. It'll be second down and 12 now.
Love mom and dad.
Time ticking down here in this first half. 5:18 to play until we reach halftime. Reeves under center. Now fires after the snap. Throws it long. Left side. We get a flag coming out on a one-on-one coverage down that left side of the field. On the coverage there for Grulla, number 10, Brian Martinez. Didn't really see much in terms of contact, but Jock Gillett on the carry there. Pardon me, was the intended receiver.
First down.
First down and 10 here for Port Isabel. Quarterback keeper as Reeves takes it left side, riding behind the tackle there. Gets across the 45 at the 44-yard line.
Brings up second down for the Tarpons. Airmail coming through. Coach Metro from IJ. Thanks for being a great coach and an awesome dad. Love IJ and Victoria.
Pitch to the right side. Vela on the carry for Port Isabel, brought down in the backfield.
Javier Vela. On the tackle, we have number 22, Robert Camarillo.
Third down and 6. Port Isabel out of the I formation, two receivers to the left. This time a different quarterback. It's Bennett again in under center. Now trying to take it down that left sideline, trying to pick up that first down. Timeout taken by Port Isabel. Fourth down and 2 coming up, 2:52. We'll take one as well here on 956sports.com.
Thursday night, we'll be having a slight chance for thunderstorms in some areas throughout the valley. The Wesco Panthers will be playing against PSJ Memorial Wolverines in partly cloudy skies with lows of 76 degrees. Now with a slight chance for thunderstorms, the Sherryland Rattlers will be facing off against Economides Jaguars at the Cat Stadium in lows of 76 degrees. Now with those same lows but partly cloudy skies, we'll have Bronzeville Veterans playing against Bronzeville Hannah. Friday night, the PSJ North Raiders will be playing their crosstown rivals, the PSJ Bears, in partly cloudy skies with lows of 77 degrees. In the Mid-Valley, the Mercedes Tigers will host the Mission Veteran Patriots and see similar temperatures as they kick off district play. Now, as most of the valley will be seeing partly cloudy skies, Raymondville will have 20% chance for thunderstorms and lows of 75 degrees as they face off against Rocky Janes and the Rio Hondo Bobcats.
Fourth down and 2 coming up here for Port Isabel. 2:52 to play. And once again, Bennett at quarterback was looking to get rid of the football, and he's sacked all the way near the 50-yard line as he was retreating and retreating and just couldn't get there. And another turnover for Port Isabel. All three drives for them have resulted in turnovers. They're going for the grand slam of turnovers here. They've got a fumble, an interception, now a turnover on downs. .245 remaining until halftime. Grulla has taken over. Another drive for them. Run to the left side. Hector Ledesma, number 34, getting the carry. He takes it to about the 45-yard line.
Hand off to number 34, Hector Ledesma. Brings up a second down.
Live score for you. Another game we have for you at 956sports.com today. Sherryland leads Economides 21-7 right now. 2-yard pickup there, by the way, by Ledesma. Second down and 8 now. Four receivers, two to the left, two to the right. Peña Blanca back to pass, fires left side. It's complete about midfield. Rudy Hernandez comes up with a reception, takes it ahead across the 45, and it's good for another Grulla first down.
For a Gator first down.
So first down and 10, under 2 minutes to play here until we reach halftime. Grulla looking to score. Remember, the Grulla started the football game receiving, so Port Isabel will get it first to start the second half. And a quarterback keeper, they fake the handoff to Ledesma, and Peña Blanca just dropped down immediately after the fake. They were not fooled at all. First quarter over. Share line up on Economides 21-7. Have that game for you also on 956sports.com. Down to a minute 12 to go. No sense of urgency, though, for Grulla to score here before the half. They're only up by 7. Port Isabel's shown the proficiency to run the football pretty well. They need to watch out. And Yablanca back to pass. Fires left side, and that pass is incomplete. And that's going to bring up third down.
Third down.
Third down and 12. Clock stops with 58 seconds remaining in the period. Four receivers, two to the right, two to the left. Peña Blanca is the quarterback. Out of the shotgun, takes the snap, looking, firing, passes complete, he's got some running room. That's Triades, and the ball comes loose, cuffed up, and it's taken now by Port Isabel after the recovery. Number 80 recovery. Ryan Vasquez, the safety, Ryan came Vasquez up with it after the initial reception by Triades. Wow.
The Tarpons will have
the football here with 47 seconds remaining. They still have two timeouts. And they'll get another go-around here to try to pick up some points here before the half. Both teams with three turnovers in the football game. Handoff goes up the middle. It's Aguilera. Powerful running there. Nearly picks up a first down. He's just shy of it. They're going to take a look. They're going to say second down and one. They need to get one more yard. It'll be second down and one. 29 seconds to go in the period. Taking their sweet time. I don't know if they're trying to get points here or not. And good blocking there. Rolling to the left. And that pass deflected and incomplete. The intended receiver there, number 12, Juan Herrera.
Up a third down.
So now it'll be third down. Clock stops with 18 seconds remaining until halftime. Kanamides has just turned returned an interception for a touchdown. And now Kanamides has cut into the lead, and it's now 21-14. Sherryland still on top
there.
Third
down and one to go.
So third and one here. Handoff goes to Aguilera, picks up the first down, pushes forward, puts his head down, and gets to midfield. Clock will stop with 13 seconds. And we'll see if Port Isabel uses one of their two timeouts, and they do use one of their timeouts. We'll take one as well. You're on 956sports.com.
And that was your two-day weather forecast. Don't forget to watch The Huddle Sundays, 9:30 a.m. on Fox 2. Also, follow me on Twitter, Oneida956.
Well, I think we don't comfort, know who we are and what we do. These girls showed up one day all dressed up, and they thought it was a dance hall. We wanted people to know that we're building materials. Mott's Cash and Carry building materials. People come in and they're surprised. Man, you guys have got great deals. I didn't know you was here. I mean, we've been here for over 40 years. And you thought the good old days were gone forever? We're still here. Mott's Cash and Carry building materials. It's not a dance hall, you know.
Here at back here at Joe R. Sanchez Stadium here in Rio Grande City. 7-0, the Grulla Gators lead Port Isabel. Tarpons have it. First and 10 at the Grulla 49-yard line. Running out of time, though, just 13 seconds remaining until we reach halftime. The quarterback, Bennett, back to pass, looking down that left sideline, and is going to run out of bounds just before the 40-yard line. About an 8-9-yard pickup there. 7 seconds remaining. Now you've reached probably the moment here. You're just going to have to send everybody deep and just kind of chuck it up there. Or unless you want to get creative here with some other type of play. Well, we had a sloppy field here about an hour ago. Pretty much a sloppy football game here in this first half. Four wide receivers are out of the shotgun here. Back to pass here. Bennett firing right side. That pass deflected, and that pass is going to fall incomplete with 1 second remaining. And now they'll let it tick off.
Your Gators 7, Tarpon 0.
That clock stopped with 1 second. 1 second to go. And they're telling the officials are telling the press box 1 second goes up on the clock. That's the correct call. So 1 second remaining. So Port Isabel will basically get to do this again. It'll be third down. They've got second down on the field, but it's definitely third down. There we go. Now the chain gang's got it right. This time they'll go under center out of the eye. And they'll pitch right side of the option. Here on that right side on the carry, there was Lasoya. Not much running room after getting across the 40. And now we've hit zeros on the scoreboard. 24 minutes of football in the books here at Joe R. Sanchez Stadium in Rio Grande City. And our score, the Grulla Gators lead this turnover fest 7-0 against Port Isabel. Like I said, turnovers all over the place. Both teams with three. Port Isabel's gotten creative with theirs. They have a fumble, an interception, and a turnover on downs. For the Grulla Gators, they've at least been deep inside Port Isabel territory with their two turnovers on downs. They've also coughed it up on a fumble. They were very, again, deep in Port Isabel territory three separate times when they've coughed it up. Two on turnovers on downs, the other on a fumble recovery. If you don't even call it that, a ball pops up, coughed out, and taken away by Port Isabel. The Tarpons haven't been able to do anything with the turnovers from Grulla. Only been able to move the ball across midfield twice, but again, nothing really doing offensively for Port Isabel. The only bright spot for them has been Aguilera, who's had a couple of nice runs. They've switched quarterbacks a couple of times, Port Isabel has, just trying to get something to happen. Grulla, on the other hand, has had some nice running from Joel Villarreal and some good receptions from the receivers. Troy Triades has a couple of good receptions. The one thing that he probably would like to have back is coughing the ball up on a fumble, because he certainly had a couple of opportunities to get in the end zone here tonight. So 7-0, again, both teams with three turnovers here after one half of football. Grulla has scored once. It was on a 1 yard touchdown run by Joel Villarreal. We'll take a timeout for halftime. We'll be back in about 27 minutes for the second half between Grulla and Port Isabel. So long for now. You're on 956sports.com.
gentlemen, welcome to tonight's halftime performance. Please join me in welcoming to the field the Siwala Sound, the pride of Port Isabel and the surrounding Laguna Madre, having advancing out 6 times in a row to the UIL State Marching Band Contest, the Port Isabel High School award-winning Silver Tarpon Band. Section of the week is the blues. Band member of the week is Alfonso Garcia. The band will be performing part of their UIL marching production entitled Firebird by Igor Stravinsky. Drum major, Ioni Rodriguez, is your band ready?
Thank you. For their continued support of the fine arts in the Point Isabel Independent School District.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the stars of our high school, the dazzling drill team from La Grulla High School Starlets. Officers for this year are junior, second-year veteran, Major Stephanie Hinojosa. Junior, third-year veteran, Captain Kyla Gomez. Junior, second-year veteran, co-captain, Yamilex Treviño. This year's sponsor is Ms. Lily Bazan. Starlet for the week is Nicole Perez. The Starlets will be performing a music selection entitled Candyman by Christina Aguilera. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy our Grulla High School Starlet. Thank you.
Way to go, Starlet. Woo! Good evening, and welcome to a state finalist Mighty Gator Band halftime performance. This year's drum majors are Miss Juliana Falcon, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Noe Falcon, Mr. Jose A. Guzman Jr., son of Mr. and Mrs. Jose Guzman, captains are Melissa Castillo, Maria Montalvo, and Sandy Medina. The show for this year is entitled Shore Lean, which is a composition of Frank Sullivan's classic Pineapple Pole, Frank Tekeli by Blue Shades, which depicts the celebration of the U.S. soldiers as they return home after a long time out at sea protecting our country. Sit back, relax, and enjoy our Gator Marching Band.
Thank you.
Welcome you back here to Joe R. Sanchez Stadium in Rio Grande City. Valley High School football here on 956sports.com. Grulla taking on the Port Isabel Tarpons, 7-0 after 24 minutes of football. It's the Gators on top of the Tarpons. And after this first 24 minutes, we've seen a lot of sloppy play. Three turnovers from both teams here in the first half. We'll see if we get a little bit more organized play here in the second half of football. Port Isabel will get the football first. They had it to close out the half, did not score. Again, as the Gators are up 7-0, Gators had their opportunities to add even more points up on the scoreboard, but just were unable to get in the end zone. They turned it over again three times. PI has had four different drives. One ended at the end of the half there. So three turnovers and one drive that just did not get finished because the half ended. Grulla, on the other hand, four drives. One ended in a score. That was their second drive of the game, and they also have three turnovers. So both of these teams are equal in the turnover sheet. Probably the one who ends up with the fewest turnovers in this game will be the one who wins the football game. Grulla in their home uniform blues, white numerals, blue pants, blue helmets. They'll be kicking off from right to left. Port Isabel in the white uniform tops, blue numerals on the front and back, blue pants, blue helmets. They'll be moving from left to right as soon as they get this ball offensively. Now kick this one off. It's kind of a line drive kick, but a booming one. And all the way into the end zone, Javier Vela comes up with it in the end zone, but he just kneels it. And the Tarpons will take over at the 25-yard line for their first drive here of the second half. Again, 7-0 our score. Weslaco up on PSJ Memorial right now, 22-3 at the half. Right now at halftime, Economides is up 35-21 on Sherryland. So a good one going on. We also have that game for you here on 956sports.com. So, run comes up the middle. Aguilera still on his feet, gets across the 40 to the 45 midfield and brought down in a shoestring tackle from behind after getting inside Gator territory. Again, number 22, Juan Aguilera on the carry. He was hit and just bounced off the would-be tacklers and gets it all the way to midfield on the first carry there. 25-yard pickup. Be first down and 10 now for the Tarpons as they try to find the equalizer here to start the second half. Ball at midfield, first down and 10. Quarterback right now is Lewis Bennett. He'll take the snap, make the handoff to the fullback, hands it to the tailback, and he's brought down immediately. Jacob Lasoya is the ball carrier. And he loss of yardage there.
On the tackle, number two, Eduardo Gallegos.
Gallegos coming up with the tackle there for Grulla.
In just a bit, we're going to have the quarterback.
Second down and about 13 to go. Ball at the 47-yard line.
Basket full of Gator goodies. Gator
memorabilia. Second and 13 here. They'll go out of the I formation. Two wide receivers. Under center is Bennett. Back. Hands it off. On the carry there, Javier Vela.
JF Utility Trenching.
Good pickup there. A 10-yard pickup.
It'll
still be third down, about three to go.
Mr. Falcon and family.
Well, about four to go, actually.
Gators.
Give them all the way to the 44-yard line. Break the huddle here. Third down and a long three here for the Tarpons. Extra tight end, hand off to the tailback, Vela. He's going to pick up the first down, gets across the 40, still on his feet.
Hand off to number seven.
Takes it all the way near the 35-yard line.
So
some power running here.
On the tackle, Brian Martinez and Joe.
The team that likes to run out of that power eye. Port Isabel trailing by seven, looking for the equalizer here. They get a first down, their second here of the drive. First down and 10 at the 36 in Gator territory, moving from left to right. Carry goes to the left side.
24,
This time the carry to Jacob Lasoya.
Tackle number 52, Joe De La Cruz. Ladies and gentlemen, make sure you go down and get yourself a roasted corn. Support
4 yard pickup, 3 yard pickup, second down and seven here. And out of that I formation, two wide receivers. Hand off again goes, quarterback keeper here. I thought it went to Vela, but on the carry there was Bennett, the quarterback. Cherryland still trailing right now. Be third down and two. Ball at the 28. 9 minutes to play in this third quarter. Still 7-0 Grulla on top. Gators will break the huddle here. Third down and a long two. Receivers over on that right side. Pitch to the left, and there was a hit immediately. If the defensive player had been standing up, he would have run into the football, and it would have been a fumble.
Jacob Lasoya brings up a fourth down for the Tarpons.
So fourth down coming up here. Fourth down at about nine. Go out of the shotgun, three wide receivers. Again, drive stalling. Oh, they'll punt the football away. It's a high punt, does not get very much on it. And it just takes a straight up in the air bounce. And the Tarpons will down it at about the 15-yard line. And that's where the Gators will take over for their first drive of the second half.
And so what else is it? Remember this number, 956-661-8000. The Salinas Law Firm helps you get the money you deserve for your injuries. If you've been injured, call the Salinas Law Firm for a free consultation.
The winner for the raffle, the quarterback club is giving out is the basket of Gator goodies. Will be raffled in just about a minute.
7:49 to go, first down and 10. Ball at the 16-yard line. Peña Blanca, the quarterback. Got his receivers bunched up on that left side. Handoff goes to the left, hit immediately. Joel Villarreal, the ball carrier.
Getting off to number 34, Hector Ledesma. The tackle, number 40, George Mondragon, brings up a second down for the Gators.
Four receivers. Back to pass here. Peña Blanca rolling to his right. Here comes the pursuit. He's going to have some running room. Gets across the 20.
Quarterback keeper brings up
goes out of bounds.
Down.
About the 22-yard line. He's going to bring up third down.
The goodie basket from Grulla Nation Quarterback Club is Mr. Fred Oviedo. Mr. Fred Oviedo, if you're in the stands, please get with one of the quarterback club members under the stands. And
so it's going to be third back. Down and four.
And you can share.
Peña Blanca, the quarterback. And we're going to get a false start penalty at the line
There's
of scrimmage.
A flag on the play.
Penalty markers come out. Bobby Rutledge will give us the official word, our referee for this one.
Ball start on the offense. 1 yard penalty, still third down.
Illegal procedure, false start against Grulla. So what was a third down and four will be third down and a long nine. So Grulla gonna have to get creative here to go to the air. Not much on this drive. Four wide receivers, three of them lined up on that right side. Low snap. Peña Blanca back to pass. Trying to find some room. Taking it left side. Looking, and just runs out of bounds. And that's not going to be good for a first down, and the Gators will have to punt the football away.
Number
6:57 to play.
Back to receive number 6, Luis Aguilera.
Punt is away. He's got a booming kick across midfield, caught at about the 40. Luis Aguilera taking it left side, gets across midfield and a tackle. There is a penalty marker down. So this one may be coming back.
There's a flag.
But a great punt there by Grulla.
Dr. Norberto Cantu Jr. handle all your dental needs, from anything from simple teeth cleanings and whitening to advanced procedures. Visit Dr. Norberto Cantu Jr.
So first down and 10 here for Port Isabel. Second drive here in the second half. Off to that right side. Vela on the carry, getting near the 30, the 31 yard line.
Brought down by number 22. That's Robert Camarillo.
Yard line, first and 10. Handoff, this time to Lasoya. Not much there for the Tarpons. Second down and 11. Out of the I formation. Run to that left side, gets across the 30. And not much else.
Michael Alaniz.
Player down for Port Isabel. And slow to get up. We're going to have an injury timeout. We'll take one as well. Here on 956sports.com.
Quadricep strain is an injury to the muscles of the anterior thigh. The muscles of the anterior thigh consist of the vastus lateralis, vastus medialis, vastus intermedius, and the rectus femoris. A strain is a tear to one of these muscles. Symptoms include a sudden sharp pain in the front of the leg during exercise, pain on stretching the thigh, pain on contracting the muscle, swelling and bruising in the thigh region, and if rupture is severe, a gap in the muscle may be felt. Strains are graded 1, 2, or 3 depending on the severity. Grade 1 consists of minor tears within the muscle, grade 2 is a partial tear, and grade 3 is a severe or complete rupture of the muscle. Physical therapy is vital for the correct rehabilitation of a quadriceps strain. This includes stretching and strengthening exercises throughout a pain-free range. If you have any further questions, please feel free to stop by our office or call us.
Quadric- 5:27 to play here in the third quarter. Still 7-0, and it looks like we've got a little short out over on the scoreboard here on our right. I'm saying the Gators are trailing the Tarpons 88-7. With the ball on the 88-yard line in quarter number 8. I never liked the fact that a lot of these scoreboards put quarter up there, because then you can't change it. You know, if you're playing soccer here, you can't put period. Or half. Nevertheless, playing football here. They do have quarters, and they fixed it. Third quarter. Third down and 10. Here come the Tarpons. Handoff goes up the middle to Javier Vela. And gets to about the 25-yard line.
Brought down by number 13, Manuel Barba. Brings up a fourth down for the Tarpons.
Fourth down and four coming up for the Tarpons. Handoff goes, no! Play action, pass over to that left side, and it falls incomplete. A little bit of tripping over your own feet there, I think, on the back pedal.
Gators will take over on down.
And once again, Port Isabel turns it over.
25-yard line.
And the Gators will take over. First down and 10 here for the Gators. Peña Blanca, the quarterback. Four wide receivers. We'll go with the end around there. And not much doing there. Number 84, Steve Seventh of the ball carrier.
Second down.
Down about 4:08 to play here in this third quarter. 7-0 Gators. That came on the second drive of the game, a 1-yard touchdown run by Joel Villarreal, and that's our only score of the football game. Second down and 13 after the 3-yard loss on the end around carry. Peña Blanca out of the shotgun, takes the snap, 3-step drop, now steps up, trying to elude the rush. Plenty of white jerseys surround him, and they bring him back down. He got across the 20. I don't know if he made it back to the line of scrimmage. Either a 1-yard loss. And we got a timeout taken by Grulla. So we'll take one as well. Grulla up 7-0 on the Port Isabel Tarpons here on 956sports.com.
You need a sports website that's not a total bomb, but they made it easier on you now. 956sports.com. Live game streaming, so sleek. Check out the cheerleaders of the week. In-depth features, articles, and reports at 956sports, 956sports.com.
Third down and 16 here. Here at Joe R. Sanchez Stadium. Grulla up 7-0, trying to get some more points. Peña Blanca escaping the pressure, gets across the 25, but he needed to get all the way to the 38-yard line to pick up a first down, so he's going to be short of it. And once again, the Gators will have to punt the football away. Both teams having trouble matriculating the ball down the field here in the second half. Fourth down and 8 as the Gators will punt the football away here. Brian Martinez in to punt it away for Grulla. Good snap on the punt. Here comes the rush. That might have been tipped. You're going to take a Grulla bounce across midfield, across the 45, still rolling. And it's going to be down at the Grulla, or pardon me, at the Port Isabel 42-yard line. That's where the Tarpons will take over for their next drive. Still trying to find the equalizer. And the scoreboard staff still trying to find that bug. The Tarpons still up 88-7. out of the I formation. They'll put a man in motion. Pitch left side. Some more strong running. This time it was number 24, Jacob Lasoya.
Okay,
about a 6-yard pickup there.
Jacob Lasoya brought down by number 31, Alan Cantu.
So second down and 4 coming up here for PI. .34 to play in this third quarter. Quarterback keeper Bennett almost had the ball stripped, and then a big hit coming from Joel Villarreal.
.5 on the tackle on number 10. It'll be Bennett.
Once again, Bennett, the ball carrier. They don't go down easily, these Port Isabel ball carriers. Aguileta, Lasoya, and even the quarterback Bennett there. Still short of the first down. 3-yard pickup, third down and 2
big
coming up.
Ball guy that's out here
right at midfield.
The Rattlers is out here making sure that they don't get hurt. Tomorrow's his birthday, Dr.
Third down and 2.
Happy birthday.
Hand off to Vela. Oh, and he's tripped up from behind. Barely got back to the line of scrimmage. And it's going to bring up fourth down. Great defensive stop by the Grulla Gators. Alanise got in there, was part of making that tackle. 17, the linebacker. So they're going to give him officially a 1-yard loss. The ball's at the 49.
Brother and your sister.
Fourth down and 3. Out of that eye. On the fourth down here. Comes Bennett, fires, and the pass is complete to Vela. And tackled from behind by Villarreal. But they pick up the first down and more as they get inside Gator territory at the 41-yard line. We've been keeping an eye on the other games across RGV High School football. Well, things may not be going well for the Harlingen Cardinals, at least on the record sheet. But their junior varsity looks to be doing well. They just beat MMA 41-0. So we can expect the Cardinals to have something as Vela breaks through the defense across the 20, the 10, the 5, touchdown Turpins.
Number 7.
And I don't see any yellow flags on the field. A 41-yard touchdown run. By Javier Vela, has the Tarpons an extra point away from tying up this football game at 7 apiece. And the kick is up, and that one is good. 33 seconds to play in this third period, and we're all knotted up. We start brand new. Gators and the Tarpons tied up at 7 here on 956sports.com. Yard touchdown run by Port Isabel's Javier Vela has tied this game up at 7 between the Tarpons and Grulla.
Wow.
The volleyball, the Grulla volleyball team.
Kickoff fair caught.
Some fried Twinkies.
About the 26-yard line. Apparently, we got some fried Twinkies downstairs. Are you, Jake, are you going down to get us some fried Twinkies? You brought enough junk food here today. Jake Berry, owner, operator, janitor, producer of 956 Sports, is here. And whenever he's producing a game, he's got to make sure he's well fed.
We had a few illegal formation by the kicking team. We'll have a re-kick. 5 yard.
Illegal procedure called against Port Isabel, and they'll kick it again. I want to welcome all of our media members from across the Rio Grande Valley who are no doubt pulling this one in tonight, keeping a close eye. I don't know if they'll admit that they're watching, but we know that everyone's watching. This is a good one. 7-0. Or pardon me, 7-7. Gators, Port Isabel. Freudian slip there. It's P.I. Kicks it off to the Gators as they try to get some points. They haven't scored since their second drive of the game. Ball is loose. They dive on top of it. They have to. And they do recover it. Coming up with it, number 12, Noe Vera. And the Gators will take it over here at about the 36-yard line. First down and 10, ball at the 36, third quarter, 29 seconds remaining in the period. Grulla from right to left offensively, and they've got the football. Out of the shotgun. Peña Blanca back to pass, fires left side immediately. Triades with the reception, runs across the 40 on the dive.
Tackled by number 11.
About the 41-yard line. About a 5-yard pickup there, so it'll be second down and 5 here for the Gators. And the time ticks down. Third quarter has come to a close. 36 minutes in the books here at Joe R. Sanchez Stadium here in Rio. And the Grulla Gators all tied up with the Port Isabel Tarpons 7-7. Teams will switch sides here on 956sports.com. So now the Gators will move from left to right across your computer screen. Port Isabel, when they get the football, will move it from right to left across your computer screen.
J3 Concrete out of Sullivan, Texas. J3 supports the Gators 100%. J3 Concrete, rebuilding the foundation of Starr County.
Bit of a delay on the field right now. So second down and 5. Three wide receivers to the right here for the Tarpons, or pardon me, for the Gators. Peña Blanca back to pass, fired and hit immediately after the catch. Triades comes up with the reception. And Triades gets it across the 45. He needs to get to the 46, though, to pick up the first down. So it'll be third down and one. Again, follow us on Twitter at 956 Sports, or you can follow me at RGV Sports Guy. Got to get those followers up. Needed 1 yard. Let's see if they can pick it up. Bouncing to the outside. They get the yard and more. Getting across midfield. There was Joel Villarreal getting it inside Tarpon territory. And they'll move the chains again here for Port Isabel. Pardon me, for Grulla. I knew this whole blue-white thing was going to mess me up at some point in this game, and it looks like it's happening here in the fourth quarter. First down and 10 here for Grulla. So we hit the 11-minute mark, remaining in regulation. Hand off. No, they'll decide not to and brought down in the backfield to tackle number 31, Gordo Garza. His name is Jose Garza, but it said, I have it here on the official Port Isabel roster, in quotation marks, meaning emphasis on the nickname, Gordo Garza. Four receivers here for the Gators, second down and 12, a long 12. Peña Blanca escapes the rush, not for long, as he's brought down, still in the backfield after the carry. Miguel Ramirez on the stop, the defensive end for Port Isabel, and that's going to bring up third down and very, very long. It's going to be third down and about, I want to say 15 or 16 here. That's a long 14 that they've got up on the scoreboard. Peña Blanca back to pass. Here comes the rush. That offensive line has been crumbling here in the second half for this Gator team, as the rush has just been coming and the pressure on Peña Blanca has been intense. After the incompletion, it'll bring up fourth down. So nothing doing there for the Gators. They'll have to punt the football away. Going deep here for Port Isabel, number 6, Luis Aguilera. Punting the football away, here's Brian Martinez. And that one is tipped. Nice job and pursuit from the special teams of Port Isabel as that one lands at about the 36-yard line, and that's where it's recovered, and that's where Port Isabel will take over. Off and some running room, still on his feet as he crosses midfield. Number 24, Lasoya, on the carry and picks up the first down. In Port Isabel, starting to put something together offensively here in the second half. They got a 41-yard touchdown run earlier by Vela, and now the team of Lasoya and Vela has been getting some serious yardage. Haven't called the number of Juan Aguilera in a while, and I think he's been the strongest runner of the bunch. Hand off up the middle here for the Tarpons. Four-yard pickup, second down and 6. center is Bennett. Pitch to Lasoya on that right side. Runs it up the hash mark.
Number 24, the ball carrier.
And another about a four-yard pickup again. He's going to be bring up third down and about two.
Run down by number 13, Manuel Barba. Brings up a third down.
It's going to be third down, and looks like they didn't give him as much as I thought. It's going to be third down and about four. Got the ball at the 43-yard line. And they need to get to the 39. Here's Vela. The ball comes loose. Beanbags come out. Who's got the football? And the referee, Bobby Rutledge, indicating immediately that it was Port Isabel who did get the football. The ball is at the 40, so it's going to be fourth down and one. Off again to Vela, gets the first down and rolls forward and gets a little bit more as he gets to the 37-yard line.
First down,
Bennett taking the snap, runs up that right hash. Time ticking down, about 6:44 to play.
It's up a second down for the Tarpons.
Second down and six. Flags come out. Looks like we'll have a false start.
False start on the offense. 5-yard penalty. Still second.
On the 5-yard penalty, that'll come back behind the original line of scrimmage. It'll be second down and 11. Under center, I formation. Bennett takes the snap, takes it right side, and got that option going. He's going to take it himself across the 25, picks up the first down. He's just shy of the red zone as he's brought out of bounds at about the 22-yard line. This one's starting to get good down here at the nitty-gritty. 5:56 to play in regulation. Timeout taken by Grulla. We'll take one as well here on 956sports.com.
Do you need a sports website that's not a total bomb? Well, they made it easier on you now. 956sports.com. Live game streaming, so sleek. Check out the cheerleaders of the week. In-depth features, articles, and reports at 956 Sports, 956sports.com.
First down and 10 here for the Tarpons. 5:56 to play in regulation. They're looking to take their first lead of the football game here late in the fourth quarter. Oh! Plenty of running room for the quarterback, Ben, as he takes it left side of the fake. The five! Touchdown, Tarpons! A great fake at the line of scrimmage. Misdirection. And the magician, Lewis Bennett, fools us all, takes it left side, down the sideline for the Tarpon touchdown, and it's now 13-7. And the kick is up. And that one, no good. Will that come back to haunt the Tarpons? We'll see. 5:49 remaining here in this one. The Tarpons up 13-7 on the Gators here on 956sports.com.
Alex, get the yardage on that.
Back at Joe R. Sanchez Stadium here in Rio Grande City. And right now, the Grulla Gators on the verge of a second half collapse, blowing a 7-0 lead at the half. 13 unanswered now for the Tarpons. 5:49 to go here in this one. Gators will get the football now, knowing that if they get a touchdown and an extra point, they'll pull ahead. Kick over to that left side of the field. And now some running room here. Triades takes it right side, trying to get outside the numbers across the 40 and dives forward. A lot of excitement for not a lot of extra yardage. Gets all the way to the 43-yard line.
Tackled at around the 43-yard line.
First down and 10 here for the Gators. Four wide receivers. Peña Blanca, the quarterback, takes the snap. Back to pass on the five-step. Liars left side, hit just as he grabbed the football. Triades took a big hit from the defense of Port Isabel. The Gators break the huddle after the incompletion, still with four wide receivers, one man in the backfield. Peña Blanca, the quarterback. He'll take the snap. Three-step drop. Steps up in the pocket, tugged on the collar of his jersey, couldn't bring him down. Penalty marker down, fires, and the pass is complete! And good enough for a first down inside Port Isabel territory, complete to number 84, Steve Cerda. But hold on, folks, this one might be coming back. This one is coming against the Gators, as Bobby Rutledge will let us know.
Holding on the offense. 10-yard penalty.
Be a hold called against the Gators. It's a 10-yard penalty. Be second down and 20 now. I have 20 to go in this one. 13-7. The Gators trail it now. Coming up 7-0 in halftime and a timeout taken by Grulla. That is their final timeout. We'll take one as well on 956sports.com.
Thursday night, we'll be having a slight chance for thunderstorms in some areas throughout the valley. The Wesco Panthers will be playing against PSJ Memorial Wolverines in partly cloudy skies with lows of 76 degrees. Now with a slight chance for thunderstorms, the Sherryland Rattlers will be facing off against Economides Jaguars at the Cat Stadium in lows of 76 degrees. Now with those same lows but partly cloudy skies, we'll have Brownsville Veterans playing against Brownsville Hannah. Friday night, the PSJ North Raiders will be playing their crosstown rivals, the PSJ Bears, in partly cloudy skies with lows of 77 degrees. In the Mid-Valley, the Mercedes Tigers will host the Mission Veteran Patriots and see similar temperatures as they kick off district play. Now, as most of the valley will be seeing partly cloudy skies, Raymondville will have 20% chance for thunderstorms and lows of 75 degrees as they face off against Rocky Janes and the Rio Hondo Bobcats.
Second down and 20 here for the Gators. They trail it 13-7. Four wide receivers, three lined up to that left side. Peña Blanca, the quarterback, takes the snap. Fires right side. He had a man, and what a grab on the interception. Number 17, Kenneth Herrera, hauls that one in, full extension grab, and the Tarpons will take over. What a pick there by Port Isabel. And 5:10 remaining in this one. Still plenty of time, but the Gators need a defensive stop. Probably an ill-advised throw there from Peña Blanca. Totally overthrew his intended target, and then, not to mention, there was a safety back ready to come up with a hit. To mention that Edda had the coverage all the way right there. Pitch goes at right side. Nothing doing there on the carry by Javier Vela.
The tackle, we have number 24.
Second down and 10 coming up here for Port Isabel. 4:40 to go. They're going to take as much time off of this clock as possible. Run to that right side. Bennett, the quarterback, the ball carrier. Going to be third down after about a 7-yard pickup. Third quarter coming to a close with PSJA. Weslaco up on PSJ Memorial 29-10. Over on that left side. McCary. Fourth down, number 24, Lasoya. The 7-R score, 3:28 to play. Time winding down on this one. Play clock just starts there. So this one will get to the 3-minute mark before they snap the ball on fourth down. And I kind of think they're going to go for it here. They are. Try to pick up that first down. And they're going to get the quarterback keeper on the sneak. He's got more than enough for the first down. He gets near midfield. So a fresh set of downs here for Port Isabel to run out the clock as we're under 3 minutes to go. Some of the Grulla faithful sort of roll their eyes back a little bit as they're seeing this football game slip away from them here at home. Both of these teams coming in at 2-2. Something's got to give. First and 10, 2:40 to play. Handoff goes to Vela. He's tackled in the backfield. Loss about a yard there. 2.5 to play in this one. Gators out of timeouts. They used them pretty early in the second half. Two very long runs from Port Isabel has them up 13-7. 41-yard touchdown run by Vela. And then 22-yard touchdown run by the quarterback Bennett. So we hit the 2-minute mark. And false start, or some sort of penalty called. It's going to be, I believe, against the Port Isabel Tarpons here. We got a good one going on between Sherland and the Cotamides. 35-28. The Cotamides up on Sherland.
Let's give it up for that Grulla High School drum line.
Clock stops with 1:59.
We have disconcerting signals on the defense. That's a 5-yard penalty. Still second down.
5-yard penalty called against Grulla. So after the penalty, it'll be 2nd down and 4. The Tarpons will break the huddle with 9 seconds on the play clock. And they'll let time tick away down to 1, take the snap. They'll run it forward. Got an extra assist there from Vela as he pushed his quarterback ahead across the chains to the 40, and that's going to do it for this one. They'll just need to kneel it here a few times. As they'll start the clock again here with 1:28 to play. Play clock starts 22 seconds. So Bennett in to kneel this one away, and a nice comeback victory for the Port Isabel Tarpons as some of the Gator faithful headed towards the exits. This one just kind of slipped away. It was really anyone's football game going into the second half. And problems with the clock here is, and now they get the play clock going. The game clock was going. But just a 7-0 lead for Grulla. And they were the ones doing a lot of things well offensively in that first half. They just turned the ball over and at the most inopportune times. They would get deep, then they'd turn it over on downs, couldn't finish the drives out. Had a couple of opportunities to get points as they get another kneel down there from Port Isabel. They're on 2nd down. It'll bring up 3rd down. They'll start the play clock. They're not going to have to take another snap here. As the two teams will line up, 17 seconds to go, and this will be a game that the Gators will look back on and said, this one slipped away from us. And frankly, slipping is a lot of what happened in that first half. The wet conditions, got a lot of rainfall here in the Rio Grande City area earlier in the day, especially right before kickoff.
And that's the end of the ballgame, folks.
Time has ticked down to zeros on the third largest scoreboard in high school football in the state of Texas. 13-7, our final here on 956sports.com. Port Isabel comes up with the victory in comeback fashion, knocking off the Grulla Gators 13-7 here at Joe R. Sanchez Stadium. And again, it's a game, as I said a second ago, that the Gators will look back on as one that slipped away. There was that big reception by Triades that slipped out of his hands as he was looking to get into the end zone. Ended up fumbling it, and ball went right back to the Tarpons, and Tigers. Another opportunity for points that they had, they just did not capitalize on. In the second half, there's not much doing. It was an interception on one drive, and then they allowed two big runs. A 41-yard touchdown run by Javier Vela and a 22-yard run by the quarterback, L.B. Bennett, the quarterback. And now the Port Isabel Tarpons improved to 3-2 on the season. Now on a two-game win streak going into their game next week against Zapata, another non-district game in the 3A ranks. It'll be their final non-district game before they start district play on the 12th of October against Progreso. As for the Grulla Gators, coming off the loss here, they've now lost two in a row and fall to 2-3 on the season. They will take on Hidalgo at Hidalgo next week. As they try to get back on the winning track and get back to 500, they'll start district play on the 12th of October when they take on Raymondville right here at Joar Sanchez Stadium. So make sure you stay tuned. We got that other game still going on. If you want to click on over, we'll give you a quick score update on that one as soon as we can. As the Sherryland Rattlers taking on Johnny Economides High School in Edinburgh today. And what a game that one has been so far. Some other scores to pass along to you. We'll try to take a look here. Weslaco up 36-10 on PSG Memorial. Let's see. Economides and Sherryland right now tied at 35. The last update we got on that one. Let's see what else is out there. Brownsville Veterans up on Brownsville Hannah 20-14, that one in the fourth quarter. So some good games going on out there. Harlingen's JV did get a victory today over MMA. I believe it was 44-0. I'll have to double check on that, but nevertheless, some good games going on. Got some big games for you tomorrow. Make sure you stay tuned, 956sports.com, for all of our coverage throughout the weekend here of Valley High School football. So that's going to do it from here. So for our producer, Jake Berry, my name's Alex Obarrio, saying so long from Joar Sanchez Stadium here in Rio Grande City. Our final score for the final time tonight, Port Isabel knocks off the Grulla Gators 13-7. This has been an exclusive presentation of 956 Sports. So long, everybody.